You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. We got all odds against us.
On woo, because everyone's screaming out woo. What does it mean for those who don't know what woo is?
Woo is just
woo's a lifestyle.
Woo's a life. Woo's woo. Woo's
a lifestyle.
Yo, secret society.
I can't say no better than that.
That's
it. I'm trying to say
woo's a lifestyle. Woo.
Can we get a big woo in the room?
Woo. Big one or two. Woo.
Every once in a while, there's an artist that comes out in hip-hop that grabs the person's ear immediately due to their distinctive sound. And in an era in hip-hop where most of the artists are sounding the same and essentially copying each other, Pop Smoke was something very different. His voice alone was something that could grab your attention even if you didn't know him as an artist. His voice was something massive.
Ain't no parking at the light. Ain't no staying in us. Keep a K with us. Please don't play with us. Nah, we up and aiming up. Ain't no hiding.
When you heard it, you knew it was coming from something way bigger than life itself, with a gritty, raw sound that I frankly haven't heard in quite some time, especially in today's era with most artists having high-pitched voices. You would think Pop Smoke was a grown man, someone possibly in his 30s who had been smoking cigarettes his whole life, but that wasn't the case. When this guy blew up, he was only 19 years old. Not only did he look like a grown man, but he had an old soul like one as well. Mix that with the gritty sound of UK's drill music and the crazy influence of the Brooklyn streets, and you got a superstar in the making that's forever going to shift the sound of hip-hop. When I first heard Pop Smoke, it was on the track PTSD. I remember scrolling my Twitter timeline and someone tweeted that track out and said, "This is the new version of 50 Cent's Miniman." And of course, me being a huge 50 Cent fan, I immediately checked the track out. However, I went into it expecting it to sound like 50 Cent's Miniman or to hold it to that light, and that was the wrong way to listen to it. So when I first heard it, I wasn't really impressed with it. But the thing that got my attention with him was his voice. And the thing about his voice was that it was either a hit or miss for the listener. It wasn't somebody in between. You either really loved it or you hated it. And for me, that's what I feel like made Pop Smoke so special, because it invoked a response. And that's always better than no response at all. After checking out the PTSD track, I went through the whole mixtape and completely fell in love with this guy as an artist. So much so that I tweeted in August of 2019 that I would love if Pop Smoke would have signed to G-Unit. It would have been a perfect fit, but at that time, I did not know he was already signed to Steven Victor's label and Universal Music Group. Bashar Jackson, also known to the world as Pop Smoke, was born on July 20th, 1999, in the Canarsie section of Brooklyn, New York. He was raised by his Jamaican mother and Panamanian father. Growing up, Pop Smoke said that he always had a musical background because his mom would sing at the church and he would join in at the church choir and sing himself. His father would also play African drums, and through the church choir singing sessions, that's how Pop Smoke learned melodies and learned how to slightly sing.
Hell yeah, I was always music. I always had like a musical background.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Mommy in church, dad played the drums and shit.
Okay.
But not like the traditional drums that we know, like the congos. And,
right. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And like play like African drums, like durumba.
Nice.
Yeah. So you know, I always had musical background.
Growing up in the Brooklyn streets, Pop Smoke says that most kids there wanted to become one of these three things: a basketball player, a rapper, or a drug dealer. And Pop Smoke says that at one point in his life, he explored all three of those. And by the time he got to middle school, he eventually involved himself in gang activity, which is where the whole Wu movement came from. Pop Smoke says that he was going in and out of school because he kept getting into fights. And in middle school, he brought a gun to class, got caught, and got kicked out. And when he's 15, he won a basketball scholarship to a Philadelphia prep school, but due to a health condition which he had, which was a heart murmur, he said he couldn't continue playing basketball, so his only option was to go to the streets. He eventually got a weapon charge for bringing that gun to class and had to wear an ankle bracelet and be on house arrest during certain times.
Of course, bro, I was on a bracelet for 2 years. What y'all call it out here?
A tag.
Yeah, we was on house arrest.
For 2 years?
For 2 years.
How old were you then?
I was, I graduated with it. And I just graduated a year ago.
Oh, for real?
So,
Oh, you were jammed.
So I had it from 17.
And that house arrest, when could you go out of the house?
Just during the day? To school.
Just to school?
That's how I graduated, because that's the only thing I could do was go to school. And work. You know what I'm saying? So I know how I feel.
And when resorting to hustling in the streets, it ended up paying off for him, because at the age of 16, he drove a BMW 5 Series. And he says because of that, it gave him a taste of the finer things in life, so he wanted to find a way to make it without any problems. And as time went on, at the age of 18, he finally graduated high school, even though he was having a lot of problems in school. Pop Smoke says that he would hang out with his homies who just happened to be rappers, and one of them was Jay Guapo. One night, he joined Jay Guapo in the studio. They ended up going to sleep, and Pop Smoke decided to take his chance at rapping.
But I knew that I could do this rapping shit the first song I made. Like I was saying, like, I made a song. I was just in the studio with the homeboys who was rapping. And I made a song with them.
Yeah.
Like, he got so high. And then I just took over.
Yeah.
And I made a song. And then I went straight to the block. I tested it out. And everybody went crazy. Crazy. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, we got this dance. You know what I'm saying? Well, this my shit. That dance right there.
Yeah.
The little leg kick shit. Once they start doing that,
you already know.
This clip, you got one. the whole hoe was behind me after that.
He says he looked up a random beat on YouTube, which happened to be 808 Mello's beat, which is a UK producer.
I found his beat on YouTube.
Okay.
Yeah.
Welcome to the party beat.
No. Panic.
Right, okay.
Yeah. No, what is it called? Criminal Link. It was one of his beats that I made NPR on.
Right, okay.
You know what I'm saying? And then I kept using his beat because I'm like, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, this worked.
So what did you do? Just rip it from YouTube? You just found
just
it and then just...
from YouTube.
Right, okay.
And the first song he recorded is a track called NPR, which stands for Money, Power, Respect. He then took the track and showed it to everyone in his neighborhood, and they all loved it. And that gave him the motivation to create more music. He ended up shooting the music video for NPR and did 10,000 views in one day. So naturally, he continued that mini buzz that he had and immediately worked on his second track. And then on January 28th, 2019, he dropped the visuals and the track for Flexing. But this track had a more direct message in it and a more aggressive one. He decided to diss the ops that he had issues with in the past. Once Pop Smoke became known, there was a video that surfaced online of him as a teenager getting smacked up by a couple of guys on the ops. Well, eventually Pop Smoke got his revenge and actually posted the video of his revenge on his official YouTube channel. I can't share it with you guys here due to YouTube guidelines, but you guys can easily find that. So on this track, he decided to take aim at them and diss a couple of other people. They of course dissed him back on other tracks, but by the time that happened, Pop Smoke started to become a household name. And that Flexing track proved to build his buzz once again, because he did 100,000 views in just one day. He continued that and recorded his next track titled Meet the Woo and dropped the visuals for it on April 16th, 2019. He says that this one got 100,000 views in just an hour, which was crazy for him because he had never experienced anything like this in terms of attention. And that attention would forever change his life. He ended up getting the attention of a producer by the name of Rico Beats, who had connections to Steven Victor, who recently launched his own label, Victor Victor Worldwide, and was looking to sign new artists. And he loved Pop Smoke's sound, so he reached out to Pop Smoke, invited him to his office in New York City. In a newly released Complex interview, they revealed the details of how everything went down. They talked, and Pop Smoke revealed that he wasn't only just a rapper, but that he could actually sing and was doing it before rapping, and he introduced a couple of tracks. The first one was the track called Something Special, in which he was remixing to Mia's 1998 hit So Into You. And this blew everyone's mind in the office because they were expecting him just to be a drill rapper, but he revealed that he was a lot more than that. So of course, Steven Victor immediately jumped at the chance to sign him, and they officially inked the paperwork in April of 2019. So Steven Victor says that him and Pop Smoke hatched a plan that he would release a couple of mixtapes focused solely on the Brooklyn drill sound. They wanted to position him as the leader of an explosive subgenre that was taking over New York City. Then once Pop Smoke was an established star with his own signature style, he would deliver his debut album, which would show his melodic side with
him. And I was like, yo, I'm watching him, right? This nigga keep playing with his phone. Like, you know, these little niggas play with their phone all the time, bro. I'm like, yo, what the fuck is wrong with this nigga, right? I'm going, what the fuck is he playing with his phone for, right? I'm in a meeting. I swear to God, this is really what happened, man. The nigga Pop Smoke couldn't see me, right? He go, yo, they sitting in there, him and his man, right? He go, yo, look, he on the phone. He like, yo, what you say? He go, he looking at his phone. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with this little nigga, right? I'm like, yo, hold up. I get up, because I'm trying to see what the fuck is he doing, right, with his phone. Like, you keep looking at his phone. I swear to God, the nigga was writing what I said down. He was writing it down. I looked, I said, oh, shit. See, it's a difference between a nigga copying you. That's not copying. That's not copying. He never copied one fucking thing from me. He just looked at it. He saw what was good in it. It influenced him, and he was doing his own thing with it. I love this shit, man. I fell in love with the nigga at that point. I fell in love with that nigga. I was like, yo. It's like, what's the matter? Yo, I like this nigga, man. I didn't know what the fuck. I was like, what else? I didn't even know how. I'm like, what are you doing? He's like, he was sitting, he was writing it. He was writing down what I was saying. So I'm like, I'm thinking this nigga's not paying attention. And he was like, nah, this nigga, whatever 50's saying, I gotta pay attention to this. And it just come from, you know, the music. You know, when you listen to the music, I don't talk gangster shit, man. They're not even going to figure out what's going on. Because the niggas in the house are not going to be running their mouth. And the niggas, the whole shit is fucked up, man. I know it's fucked up. But it's gangster.
Breaking news from LAPD this morning. Detectives have arrested five people in connection with the murder of rapper Pop Smoke. 20-year-old Bashar Jackson was shot and killed by several masked men during a home invasion robbery in Hollywood Hills back in February. Earlier, police have said the shooting may have been gang-related.
Hello, I'm Mark Brown.
Multiple LAPD Hollywood units responded to a call at 2033 Hercules Drive in the Hollywood Hills. The radio call was called in by someone from back east and stated a friend of theirs' home was being broken into by multiple suspects and that one of them was armed with a handgun. When officers arrived there approximately 6 minutes later, they discovered a victim inside the house had been shot. They called the fire department, who arrived and transported that victim to Cedars-Sinai Hospital, where he was pronounced dead some hours later. I'm not sure of the time he was pronounced. Officers detained several people who were inside the house. However, all of those folks were released. It was widely reported that someone at the scene was arrested. That is not true. No one was arrested at the scene. It has also been widely reported that the victim is a music star of some import. We have not confirmed the identity of the victim yet, so we are not stating that. Operations West Bureau Homicide is investigating this. They're at scene now, and they'll have more details as the day goes on. And again, I apologize, but that's all we have at this point. And I take questions if you have it. Yes, sir, the 911 call came from back east. It was apparently a friend of someone who was inside the residence who had been contacted from inside the residence and had in turn called 911.
How many people are in the home, do you know?
I don't know. I don't know who owns the house.
Can you confirm the house was being used as an Airbnb?
I don't know if the house was being used as an Airbnb.
Are you releasing the name of the victim?
No. It's reported out there, but we haven't confirmed the identity of the victim. He appeared to be about 20 to 30 years old. No, only one person was shot. Yes, there were several witnesses, and they're being interviewed by homicide detectives now.
I know it's early in the investigation, but obviously neighbors are concerned. Is there any indication that this could have been a targeted attack, shooting, or this was a random home invasion?
Yeah, it's a really good question that we just don't know yet. Again, we're just starting to interview folks. I know this is very preliminary.
There were reports that suspects may have worn masks.
Yes, at least one of the suspects was wearing a black mask when they entered the house.
How many suspects do you believe there were?
There are varying reports between 2 and 6. So depending on which version is correct, it's between 2 and 6.
And how many people were inside the home?
I don't know. I think someone just asked that. Yeah.
You say suspects?
Yes.
Do you believe it was a robbery attack?
Yeah, we don't know yet. In a few hours, when Homicide has done some witness interviews, I'm sure I can get you guys more info. I apologize.
that blicky chain on, nigga.
Look,
take it off, nigga.
Look, all of them niggas know I be flexing. I did 15 on my check-in. Been a little bit time when I'm stepping. Big 38 for the weapon. All of them niggas know I be flexing. I did 15 on my check-in. Big 38 for the weapon. We gon' hit him and finish him. Nobody innocent. If you ain't dead, better lay down. All the judges giving sentences. Free on my minutes. All in the island like what now? Flex in the jungle where niggas gon' rumble. I aim at your head, we don't spray ground. We don't shoot one or two, we gon' boom up the room. Back of the chop, we gon' spray rounds. Say that 40 Jody, roll a 40 clip. I bet I make his ass to 40 clips. Shepchi, sauce him up. Shepchi told me, sauce him up. Fuck Iggy, tell Shannon he can suck a dick. Bullets leaving him sleepy like hollow. One in the head if a nigga won't follow. Niggas only respect you because your brother. People punch you when you caught your mother. That's what brothers do for one another. That's the only reason I ain't put you under. That double G will make a nigga cry. Talking big Kiki till a nigga hot. I can't trust your bitch because these bitches lie. And that's how I cover my niggas die. Yeah, I'm big on that too. Woo. I'm posted on the lens, I be forcing. Belly truck when I'm sliding, my bitch is exotic. My hands off the wheel when I'm parking. Jameis told me get the cash. I'm married to denims, don't ask what it cost. He gave me to the course if he SRK. Let's talk about it if you feel the way. Nigga, everything cake. Big 24, don't call me bluff. Keep down the door. Big on that too. Show the remorse. Mind designer, all in the stores. Can't you out, make you a whore. Find my little guys, to stay on the floor. I make a call, bitch in this wall. Do this right, I'm 4-4. Pull up TV, I got 10 in my jeans. Open with me, listen TV. Patek Philippe, Givenchy T. I need a meal, been in the streets. Put it on floors, come to the east. L-O-A-B, give me free reed. Shooters and plies, stay with the sleeves. Or I call an ape, free money G. All of them niggas know I be flexing. I did 15 on my check-in. Been a little bit time when I'm stepping. Big 38 for the weapon. All of them niggas know I be flexing. I did 15 on my check-ins. Big 38 for the weapon.